Going class where we are going to see second program in your syllabus, that is insert an element in array. Insert an element in an array. So listen very carefully in this one, because this, if you understand, then the next program will be very easy for us. Okay. So insert an element in an array. I'll give an example for this. Okay. Think that you are typing, or you are typing in your mobile or in your computer. You are typing in this manner. What happened here? Yes. What you are seeing, it is correct. I made a spelling mistake there. And what was the spelling mistake there? I have not typed U. So normally what you do is, listen carefully, normally what you do is, you take the cursor, you take this cursor, this is what is the cursor, when it tells you to type, you take this cursor and you are going to place a T. You are going to place a T. Okay, we are going to place a T. Now, what you are going to do here? Immediately, you are going to type U. You are going to type what? U. Immediately, what happens after that? What happens after that? U is being inserted. U is being inserted. How it is going to be inserted? How it is going to be inserted? I say, okay. So this is just a live example. How what you are reading is not waste, but you have to think this one. What you are reading is not totally waste. It is being used in the daily life. It is used in the daily life. You have to understand. Concentrate here. Concentrate all of you. Keep all the things aside and concentrate a lot here. So what you do is you take this example to the consideration and you listen for the class. Okay. Now. Example, you take n equal to 4. Then how many array elements I am going to get? How many array elements I am going to get? Each of the array, we call it as a unit, is called as a node, N-O-D-E node. So we are going to get 4 nodes for it. Listen carefully. So 4 nodes in our language, we call it as 4 houses we are going to get. We are going to get 4 houses. Okay. Now, A0. A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, correct? A of 0, A of 1, A of 2, A of 3. We are going to get this many array elements. Correct, once again. But if n equal to 4, the 4 array elements, A of 0, A of 1, A of 2, A of 3. Now you can give any elements here, your wish. You can give any elements here, it is your wish. So you can give here 5, 8, 9, 2, like this. Any elements you want, you can give. Okay, this is called as inputs. What is called as inputs? It is called as inputs. So you are given here some elements, you are given 7, 8, 9, 2, like this, you are given some elements. Now, example, you take a very nice example like you. This is a very good idea. Think that there are 4 students sitting in a bench. This is a bench meeting. And these are the roll numbers. Okay, roll number are they are represented with this number, you think. Okay, 7, 8, 9. Now, what I'll say is, I'll come into your class. I'll say that in this position, I want a new boy to come and sit. Example, the new boy name is number is 3. I want you that boy to be sat in here. They have to sit there. So what they are going to do? Now it becomes 5. Okay, whatever it is, it becomes 5. Now, they are going to keep an idea. Here, a boy can ask it on this board. Correct? What they have to do now? Now, they will take already some space will be there beside this boy is shifted here. This boy is shifted here, our student, and this is shifted here. Now it is empty. Now you insert this here. Finished. A simple thing. I'm entering the class. Last who is last? Just I'll say to move aside. Again, I'll move aside. Again, to move aside. I'll make empty space in the between. I'll say a new student to sit there. Correct? Correct, all of you? Understood? Chat and say understood. Clearly, how it happens, you understood? Chat and say, mom. To be very quick, chat and say, you understood? Clearly, you understood the example. Here, what I have done, four students have taken. So,
at last, there will be an empty space, A of 4, already to be there. A of 10, you are going to declare, na? A of 20, that means less to be there, but I am implying only A of 4. So, A of 4 will be there, just very simple, just skip the last one here, last here to here, and here to here. It will be empty here.
Clear? All of you? Clear? Now, here, two things. Two things are there.
Okay, let us see that one. This is a programming. I have to write a logic for this. How I'm going to write that you are going to see. Okay? Now, you see here. Which position is there that I have to say? First input is L. Second input is R. That many R elements I have to enter. Third input is which position? Whichever it is. If I say 1, this will be empty. If I say 2, this will be empty. If I say 3, this will be empty. So whichever position I am going to say, which user is going to say, which program is going to say, that should be empty. That should be empty. So here, I am giving it as position equal to 1. You can give it as any number, no, you can give it as 0 also. That will be empty for us. Now, element to be inserted in this position, which element you want? Example, I want 3. The same element I take 3. So we have 4 inputs, M, array, position, element to be inserted. How many inputs we have here?
Chat and say how many inputs we have? How many inputs we have? That should be very quick. How many inputs we have? Very good, very good, very good. We have 4 inputs.
The first input is N, array, position, then element should be inserted, and element to be inserted. Clear? All of you clear? Clear?
Now next. Next. Logic. Very important.
This is logic. You have to come up for this. You have to understand it. Okay? Okay, now as I said you, here this boy has to go here. This boy has to go. Listen very carefully. Concentrate a lot on it. Keep everything aside. Concentrate a lot. Now this element has to go here. Correct? So here it has to go. Yes. I will be standing here. Have to write now. Where it has to go? Last boy should come here. I will be standing at the last position. This one. Here I will be standing. I'll say this boy to come here. So my starting point and ending point you have to note. You have to note my starting point and ending point. Okay? My starting point is what here? What it is? It is? Chat and say what it is? What it is? What you are saying here? My starting point is?
No. N minus 1, 4 minus 1, it becomes 3. No, it is not N minus 1. It is not N minus 1. No. Still,
No, it is not. Should not say A of 4. Still, n minus 3, 4 minus 3 is 1. Should be thinking. Still think. What it is? Still, use common sense. Ma, use common sense here. 4 is what it is. N. N is 4. N. Very good. It is N. So starting point is what for me? N. Ending point. Let me see who is going to say it correct. Ending point is 1. Ending point is what? Yes, this is the starting point, and it is going back. Going back is what? If it is going front, plus plus. If it is going back, minus minus. You have to concentrate here. If it is going back from n to what value? 1. 1 means what? 1 means what? Chat and say 1 means what? P. Very good. It is P. 1 means 8. It is P. P. As you are seeing here, P equal to 1. P equal to 1. So instead of 1, what I can write here? P. So starting point is what here? Whatever is the number. Whatever may be the number, you don't see that 1. You have to see only the value which is taking the number. That is 4 means N, 1 means P. 1 means what? P. Clear all of you? See any doubts here? Clear? Clearly understood? See any doubts here? Chat and say. Yes, very good. So, let me write the logic here. Let me write the logic. So, for I equal to, from where it starts, N. Then, I, it is moving back. I moving back means greater than. Listen very carefully this one. Whenever it is moving front, means forward, less than. If it is moving back, back is what? It is going backwards. It is greater than. I greater than. When it will be greater than? Whenever it is going back. So I greater than. What value it is? P. And I going back is I minus minus. I minus minus. Clear? I minus minus. Okay? Then next. Here, next logic. A of 3 value has to go for A of 4. A of 3 value has to go for what? A of 4. So A of 4 is a getting here. A of 4 should have A of 3 value is aligning. It has to be aligned in this manner. So what you have to do is a very, very, very carefully here. So I equal to N. N value is how much here? 4. So I equal to 4. Correct? All of you. I equal to N. When what is the value of N? 4. So I value will be what? 4. Correct? Correct all of you? Understood? Chat and say you understood? I value is 4. You understood how it is? Why? Because n equal to 4, I have written I equal to n there. And see, I have written I equal to n, so I value will be also 4. Clear? All of you? Clear? I'm going very slow, ma. You have to understand here. My students should understand, never by heart. Okay? Okay. Very good. So, it is I equal to 4. So, A of 4 is what I can write here? I. Equal to A of 3. What I can write? A of 3 means what I can write? Chat and say. A of 4, instead of 4 I have written I equal to A of 3, what I can write? 2. No. A of, no, we are not sending the value here. We are sending, we have to write the logic for it. No. Element is never considered. Very good, very good. Girishma, it is I minus 1.
I value is how much? 4. 4 minus 1 is how much? 3. So a of I means 4 equal to a of I minus 1 means what? It is 4 minus 1. It is 3. So you have to get in this manner. So a of I equal to a of I minus 1. Practice this only logic today for 4 to 5 times or 10 times also. Only the logic part. You will be perfect, ma. Will you do it? Yes or no? Will you do it? Practice this logic for 4 to 5 times or 10 times also. You have to do it. Why? Because each program carries, never forget, it carries 14 marks. Okay? So, here, now. A of which value is empty? Very good, Swati. It is P. You should say P. Why? Because P equal to 1 now. So as I said, you input can be given anything. So position will be empty, you have to say. So A of P, 3 should be inserted. What is that element? So A of P equal to element. I'll say once again. A of P equal to element. What is one is P. So what is going to write here? A of P equal to element. Means A of P is storing element 3. So we are going to write here. Here you are right. Where you have to. Only this statement belongs to 4. I repeat. Only this statement belongs to 4. So A of P equal to element. Now, how many elements you are seeing now in an array?
You count and see. How many elements now you are seeing in an array? Initially it was 4. Now how many you are seeing? Very good. It is 5. Correct? Initially it was 4. Correct? Starting, I have given the example. Initially 4 students were sitting. One more is added. So 5 students will be sitting. Correct? So what happens here? One student is increased. One student is increased. Increased means what? One student is increased means n value is been
incremented by 1. N initially was 4. Now you count. What is the value of n? It is 5. So whenever I say one value is increased, listen very carefully. One value is increased means one value is incremented. One value is incremented. Incremented, you know, it is plus plus. So what I want right here? Yeah. Clear, all of you? Clear? Any doubts here? I'll revise once again. Okay? Clear, all of you? Clear here? Very good, ma'am. Very good. So my students should be with this much amount of confidence. Students, and see this video. I'll send the video afterwards. See this video for 4 to 5 times. Clearly, you'll understand. Okay? So I'll write off the logic. Once again, see how simple it is. It is 4 lines, but never by heart. I don't like a student to be bahated. Okay, so for I equal to, from where it starts, n. It is going back. You have to think in this manner. It is going back. So I greater than p. I minus 1. So A of 4 should have A of 3 value. As you know, A of 4 should have A of 3 value is I value equal to 4, A of I equal to A of I minus 1. Then this, what is that? A of P equal to element. So never forget all this you have to keep in mind. And initially the number was 4. Now it is increased to 1. So it is n. Clear? Clear, all of you?
and see this video for 4 to 5 times, still it will be clear for all. Okay, so this is the logic. But if a user, listen very 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 carefully here, if the user is giving beyond the array value, example only 5 students can sit, I'll say 10 students you come and sit in one bench, will it be possible? If I give 10 number and ask them to sit a 10th location, where the 10th location is there, only 5 numbers are there, more than n value can I give? If n equal to 5, maximum 5 students can sit. If I say more than 10 value to be sat, will it be possible? No. So never, listen very 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 carefully, never give your p value, this value should not cross your n, it should not be more than n. If it is more than n, it is invalid position. I repeat once again, this position value, it is an input given by the user, it should never 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 be more than n value. Okay, then you have to write a message for it and a condition stating that if p is greater than n, first only you have to write this one, see out what you want to write, invalid position. Else now means you can do it wrong. Else means if it is less than n, this operations are done. If it is more than n, condition is given, invalid position. Clear all of you? So this is your logic.
So tomorrow I'll give this program neatly. After I've been explained this program how to write, then I'll send you this one. You write that in your observation. I was very 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 happy, ma, about all the students, they have written the observation, sent to me. Really I'm very happy. And execution also I have shown you in the same manner. I'm going to continue. Say it is interesting, we'll continue in this manner only. I'm trying my maximum so that you can understand the execution part also. Say, catch and say. Okay, very good, very good. So tomorrow again one we are going to meet. Then we are going to see the next program how to be written. Then I'll send you the program. You write and keep. Again the same method. Again I'm going to type the program, explain you. Then how to give the inputs, everything I'm going to do. Okay, good. So be attentive, be listening for the classes. Thank you. Have a good day.